Freedom Works hosts a virtual press conference with members from Congress to stress the biggest threats to our election system and educate voters as well. One America's Caitlin Sinclair reports.
Adam, thanks for coming on. Your organization has done so much great work for the fight of election integrity. Now, you were joined by members of Congress recently to continue this discussion. And one thing I heard Congressman Andy Briggs of Arizona stress is having someone physically there when folks are opening their mail-in ballot. And this is something we are already experiencing massive issues with here in New York. Botched ballots, so many errors. What are the studies showing, and what can you tell us about what Freedom Works specifically has been doing to educate those voters about mail-in ballots?
So Freedom Works is a grassroots activist group. So we look at our job as training grassroots citizens to be engaged. It's not grassroots is not watching TV and voting. Grassroots is actually going out and getting involved in the process. We have seen multiple studies that show if there is someone watching, the chances of malfeasance happening goes down dramatically. Just having someone there overlooking at the process helps keep everything honest. And then when you get into the recounts and the counting, we want to make sure that they're not going to have polling locations where you don't have various people from the outside taking a look to make sure that the system is working. So there's a variety of ways that we're training people.
Now, Adam, you brought up this point yourself. Over the past 4 years, we've heard the mainstream media telling us President Trump is undermining democratic norms. Yet, if you look to last week, for example, Biden's refusal to answer the question of will he pack the court, it shows us he is very much determined to implement radical changes to the way the Senate operates. Does this not undermine these democratic norms that we've been hearing about for 3.5 years?
But what you are hearing from the Democratic Party and Joe Biden in the debate refused to take a stand on court packing. He refused to take a stand on fundamentally eliminating the filibuster. And once you get rid of the filibuster, you no longer have the Senate as a separate body. The Senate basically becomes an upper house of Congress. And once you get into that world, it is going to be incredibly easy to pass legislation. And that is not how our system was designed.
Not at all how our founding fathers designed the system. And just to make this point, once it does become easy to pass legislation, all bets are off. You'll be able to have 12 Supreme Court justices. You could have 20. Now, Congressman Matt Gaetz was very passionate about this during your webinar. He also mentioned the Democrats are taking advantage of this pandemic. Of course, we saw that play out 1,000 times this weekend. But he says they're doing this in order to create this electoral advantage. And the big why, he said, is that the left actually believe President Trump will win the Election Day vote. So they want to create this period of time after the election where there's so much uncertainty.
This is exactly why we're trying to train our activist community to be involved in the electoral process, to get involved at their local board of elections and be ready for these recounts where much of this is going to be settled. So it's very important that they hear from our activist community that rules are rules. They should be followed. You don't change the rules in the middle of an election.
Once you start doing that, we start messing with the basic fundamentals of how we understand our system to work. Thank you so much, Adam.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.